Hello and welcome to the Daily Vision Bible. I'm Rabbi Yates and we are getting even closer to the end of Deuteronomy now. Over the next few days I will be reading the last three chapters that it is claimed were written by Moses. An amazing role model for people to be inspired by. Social outcast, a powerful preacher of God's word. If only we had more role models like that. Deuteronomy chapter 32 today. Let's open God's word with prayer. Lord, I ask that as I read your word, you reveal something new to me. I also ask that as people hear your word, they come to a better understanding of you. Amen. Give ear, you heavens, and I will speak. Let the earth hear the words of my mouth. My teachings will drop as the rain. My speech will condense as the dew, as the misty rain on the tender grass, and the showers on the herb. For I will proclaim Yahweh's name. Ascribe greatness to our God. The rock, his work is perfect. For all his ways are just. A God of faithfulness who does no wrong, just and right is he. They have dealt corruptly with him. They are not his children, because of their defect. They are a perverse and crooked generation. Is this the way you repay Yahweh, foolish and unwise people? Isn't he your father who has bought you? He has made you and established you. Remember the days of old. Consider the years of many generations. Ask your father, and he will show you. Your elders, and they will tell you. When the Most High gave to the nations their inheritance, when he separated the children of men, he set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel. For Yahweh's portion is his people. Jacob is the lot of his inheritance. He found him in a desert land. In the waste, howling the wilderness. He surrounded him, he cared for him, he kept him as the apple of his eye, as an eagle that stirs up her nest, which flutters over her young. He spread abroad his wings, he took them, and he bore them on his feathers. Yahweh alone led him. There was no foreign god with him. He made him ride on the high places of the earth. He ate the increase of the field. He caused them to suck the honey out of the rock, oil out of the flinty rock, butter from the herd, and milk from the flock, with fat of lambs, rams of the breed of Bashan, and goats with the finest of wheat. From the blood of the grape you drank wine, but Sheshiron grew fat and kicked. You have grown fat, you have grown thick, you have become sleek. Then he abandoned God who made him, and rejected the rock of his salvation. They moved him to jealousy with strange gods. They provoked him to anger with abominations. They sacrificed to demons, not God, to gods they didn't know, to new gods that came up recently, which your fathers didn't dread. Of the rock who became your father, you are unmindful, and the forgotten God who gave you birth. Yahweh saw and hated because of the profligation of his sons and his daughters. He said, I will hide my face from them. I will see what their end will be, for they are a very perverse generation, children in whom there is no faithfulness. They have moved me to jealousy with that which is not God. They have provoked me to anger with their vanities. I will move them to jealousy with those who are not a people. I will provoke them to anger with a foolish nation. For a fire is kindled in my anger, that burns to the deep soul, devours the earth with its increase, sets the foundation of the mountains on fire. I will heap evils on them. I will spend my arrows on them. They shall be wasted with hunger, and devoured with burning heat and bitter destruction. I will send the teeth of animals on them, with the venom of vipers that glide in the dust. Outside, the sword will kill, and in the room's terror, both young man and virgin, the nursing infant, the grey-haired man. I said that I would scatter them afar. I would make their memory to cease from among men, were it not that I feared the provocation of the enemy, in case adversaries should judge wrongly, in case they should say, our hand is exalted. Yahweh has not done all this. but they are a nation void of counsel. There is no understanding in them. Oh, that they were wise, that they understood this, that they would consider their latter end. How could one chase 1,000, and 2 put 10,000 to flight, unless their rock had sowed them, and Yahweh had delivered them up? For their rock is not as our rock, even our enemies themselves concede. For their vine is of the vine of Sodom, and fields of Gomorrah. Their grapes are poison grapes, their clusters are bitter. The wine is the poison of serpents, the cruel venom of asps. Isn't this laid up in store with me, sealed up among my treasures? Vengeance is mine, a recompense. At that time when their foot slides, for the day of their calamity is at hand. Their doom rushes at them. For Yahweh will judge his people, and have compassion on his servants, when he sees that their power is gone, that there is no one remaining, shut up, or left at large. He will say, where are their gods? The rock in which they took refuge, which ate the fat of their sacrifices and drank the wine of their drink offering. Let them rise up and help you. Let them be your protection. See now that I myself am he. There is no god with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. There is no one who can deliver out of my hand. For I lift up my hand to heaven and declare as I live forever. If I sharpen my glittering sword, my hand grasps it in judgment. I will take vengeance on my adversaries, and will repay those who hate me. I will make my arrows drunk with blood. My sword shall devour flesh with the blood of slain and captors, for the head of the leaders of the enemy. Rejoice, you nations, with his people, for he will avenge the blood of his servants. He will take vengeance on his adversaries, will seek cleansing for his land and for his people. Moses came and spoke all the words of this song in the ears of the people, he and Joshua the son of Nun. Moses finished reciting all these words to all Israel. He said to them, set your heart to all the words which I testified to you today, which you shall command your children to observe to do, or the words of this law. For it is no vain thing for you, because it is your life. Through this thing you shall prolong your days in the land, where you go over to Jordan to possess it. So he spoke to Moses that same day, saying, go up into this mountain of Arabim, to Mount Nebo, which is in the land of Moab, which is across from Jericho, and see the land of Canaan, which I give to the children of Israel for possession. Die in the mountain where you grow up, we gather to your people, as I and your brother died at Mount Hor, must go to his people, because you turned against me among the children of Israel at the waters of Meribah of Kadesh in the wilderness of Zin, because you didn't uphold my holiness among the children of Israel. You shall see the land from a distance, you shall not go there into the land which I give the children of Israel.